It all started when our partners at American Bird Conservancy reached out and said, you've got this great banding station. You're banding birds daily. You have a great avian research center. Would you be willing to host a brand new testing tunnel to test the effectiveness of bird-friendly glass? And we said, absolutely. Our Foreman's Branch Bird Observatory bands close to 15,000 birds a year. It's an incredible project that's been going on for almost over 20 years. We have a long-term data set, a great team, and we work with Washington College students directly to make this happen. What a wonderful opportunity for our students to handle wildlife, learn about wildlife, collect raw data and statistics, and transform it into scientifically relevant and credible information. So when ABC reached out to us, the reason they did so is because we have this great bird banding effort. We have literally birds in hand. And they were looking for those birds so that they could use them in their glass collision testing tunnel to test bird-friendly glass.
American Bird Conservancy has been testing glass for over a decade with another site in Pennsylvania. And there has become such a demand for bird-friendly glass due to a lot of legislation coming out, as well as glass companies wanting to get ahead of the curve and have bird-friendly glass available all over the world. In the United States, it's estimated that about 1 billion birds die a year because of collisions with windows. We are starting to recognize that this is a problem globally and as well as in North America. So the whole purpose of this tunnel being built is to allow us the wiggle room to conduct research with certain groups that are trying to develop new technologies with bird-friendly materials, as well as to approve more bird-friendly materials that are already on the market or trying to come into the market. In order to do the project that we're doing with this glass testing tunnel, we need birds. And Foreman's Branch Bird Observatory is affiliated with Washington College, and they get such an immense amount of birds, honestly, throughout the year, but more during spring and fall migration. Where we are in Chestertown, Maryland, where Washington College is and Foreman's Branch Bird Observatory, it's right along the coastline, and it hugs the Atlantic Flyway, which birds use to migrate to their breeding grounds as well as to their wintering grounds. There are just so many birds at this location coming through down the Atlantic Flyway or up the Atlantic Flyway that it would allow us to test so many more potential bird-friendly materials.
The tunnel itself, all inside is completely dark. There's no light coming through at all. The only light that the birds will see while they're in the tunnel is coming through two glass panes at the very end. Birds will fly towards light naturally, so they'll be flying towards the end of the tunnel. The end of the tunnel itself is divided into two different panes of glass. One is a clear control pane, and then one is the pattern that a glass company came up with. So we'll test them side by side, and then we video each bird flight to see which side they want to go towards. There is a net before the glass. We are not having birds, you know, fly into glass, because then that wouldn't be bird friendly at all. So we have a little net right in front of the glass. So they'll kind of just hit it, has a bit of give, they bounce right off, and then I open a door and they fly right off. We want the birds to go towards the control side because that means that the pattern side is effective in stopping collisions. So it's a bird-friendly way to test collisions.
The fact that Washington College is now hosting one of only two bird-friendly glass testing tunnels in the entire United States on our River and Field campus is of interest because it immediately has doubled the amount of bird-friendly glass testing that's available for the glass industry, for the construction industry. That's incredible for bird conservation. That was a great fit for us just because of our banding station, but we also said, yes, let's do this partnership because we knew it would be a great opportunity for our students. So students that are in class right now are visiting with Meghan McHenry, who just graduated from Washington College and who we hired to operate the tunnel. She shows our students, here's a field-based job that you could have. Here's how I got to where I got. And an example, it's a way for our students to put themselves in someone else's shoes and see, I can work in the field, I can work in the environment, and here's what I might be doing. Hands-on conservation, working practically and seeing the kind of science that is required for us to then to determine what is truly bird-friendly glass, take that bird-friendly glass, and present it to policymakers and say, this is something we can put into our buildings. And then policymakers enacting laws that say we should have a level of bird-friendly glass in our buildings, our new buildings, like New York City has recently done. That's the full spectrum of science moving to action, moving to implementation. And our students get to witness that from the start, right away, at Forman's Branch Bird Observatory.